At today's press conference, amid the seasonal warnings about drinking and driving, the minister did come up with some remarkably good news. Drink driving, he said, is on a very pronounced downwards path. In other words, over the past few years, less and less people are driving when they have a good prospect of killing others. But to make sure it stays that way, the government want us all to realise just how unpleasant it is to be arrested for drinking and driving. The government say it's a humiliating experience, with pockets emptied and tie and shoelaces removed. They laid on a realistic impersonation of an arrest and detention for mixing drink and driving.
It's the wimp who just drinks and drives because they think it's socially necessary. It's not. We do need to break the link between the throttle and the bottle. And for those who get banged up in a cell like this, if this helps get the message across, it's worthwhile. We want to make it the best Christmas ever for the 100 families who between now and New Year's Day would otherwise have to be arranging a funeral rather than having the family reunion celebration.
The news that fewer are drinking and driving is confirmed in a report from an insurance company that says that the capital is now the country's driest area, with 18% of adults no longer drinking. And the trend is led by women. Over one in five London women no longer drink alcohol. Ray, do you agree that things are getting better?
Certainly there are more people now who are behaving very sensibly when it comes to drinking and driving. There are still far too many who do drink and drive. Despite the improvement, between 12 and 1,500 people get killed on our roads each year in drink-drive accidents. That's far too many.
And to keep the numbers falling, the police will be enforcing the drink laws firmly this Christmas. Simon Neave, Thames News.